gonna sign this damn thing, give me a hell yeah.
Hollywood Park in Inglewood, California.
The face! Austin's been badly lacerated. This McMahon just signed the contract for Fully Loaded in Austin's own blood.
Undertaker, you want my blood? I want a piece of your ass. And Steve, he's recruiting his little brother.
The Undertaker and Kane looking eye to eye.
Let's Stone Cold Steve Austin and the Big Show send those two freaks to hell.
Somebody's gonna get hurt bad here tonight. You can feel it. And the Rock's taking his fight back. And he's got his body. Yes. My God, what a chokeslam. The Undertaker has opened Austin up again the second time tonight. Stone Cold Steve Austin has been busted open. And if that happens, as Fully Loaded, the Undertaker will be the WWF champion.
Undertaker, Michael, holds the fate of both Stone Cold and Mr. McMahon in his hands.
So, Austin, how does it feel? How does it feel to taste your own blood? You see, Austin, I have dreams at night now, and what I dream of is the wound in the top of your head, and the blood pours from it. It gushes until your whole rotten carcass is covered with the stench of your own stinking blood.
The Undertaker is demonic, the embodiment of evil.
Austin is only one man, and one man can't beat the Undertaker. Fully Loaded, Austin, it is inevitable. I will be once again the World Wrestling Federation champion, and I will bust his head open. I will taste his blood. I will revel in it. I will come more powerful. Oh, yeah. There's one more thing, Austin. Your worst nightmare has come true, because the brothers have reunited.
Reaffirmation of what we learned last Monday.
Oh, boy.
It was 13 months ago with Kane as the opponent in the first ever First Blood match. It was The Undertaker who drew Austin's First Blood. Now with Kane and The Undertaker back together once again, I'm sure not only old wounds are slow to heal, but I'm sure painful memories die hard. And there you see the brothers, eye to eye, face to face in the middle of the ring. And the pendulum seems to have swung to The Undertaker's side. Also have to say, advantage Mr. McMahon. He has to be thrilled with the reuniting of The Undertaker and Kane. So much at stake in that First Blood match next Sunday for Mr. McMahon. If Austin can somehow pull off a victory, we'll never see the boss of the WWF again. But the demonic duo has returned. The Undertaker and Kane, the evil presence filling this arena. Folks, you don't need any more evidence than that. The brothers have reunited, The Undertaker and Kane, and that can only spell doom for Stone Cold Steve Austin next Sunday on pay-per-view and Fully Loaded. But tonight on Heat, what a show. The Intercontinental title on the line.
We're going to find out if Jeff Jarrett's ready to do it doggy style. He'll defend against the Road Dog.
We're going to hear from the world's most dangerous man, Ken Shamrock. Sure, he's going to have plenty to say about the lethal weapon, Steve Blackman.
And I've got to wonder what X-Pac thinks about the brothers reuniting. Great friends with Kane and all. We'll see X-Pac in action one-on-one against Hardcore Holly.
And what about this colossal matchup? Triple H in the Big Show right here tonight on Heat. The Golden Couple, Jarrett, Deborah, are next on Heat.
Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Accompanying the Intercontinental Champion of the Ring. Huge matchup tonight on Sunday Night Heat. Jarrett and the Road Dog.
What is this, a damn kennel? No more puppies until you people start showing me the proper respect. I am the greatest Intercontinental Champion of all time, whether you like it or not.
Well, that's what he says.
Now, as far as Stone Cold Steve Austin goes, Austin, don't even think about gunning for my belt after you lose yours and Fully Loaded. 'Cause, son, I ain't no redneck from Texas. I'm a champion, a true champion, the greatest intercontinental champion of all time.
tonight he has a chance to win the Intercontinental Championship. And it sounds to me like Jeff Jarrett's focus and thoughts are on Stone Cold Steve Austin and not on the Road Dogg. Do you think Jarrett believes that the Undertaker is the favorite for next Sunday's first blood match, the Undertaker and Stone Cold Steve Austin?
I don't think Jarrett's alone in those thoughts.
Music. You know, I'm not in the market for a new dog, but I sure love looking at some puppies. And I want to welcome you all to the dog house. Now then, let's get busy and kick this year's net doggy style. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children.
Oh! Jeff Jarrett hammering away now on the Road Dogg, still in a foul mood from what happened this past week. And look at Jarrett go.
Boy, oh boy, the burgeoning mean streak within the Intercontinental Champion. First jealous over Deborah's popularity, and now irate over Stone Cold stunning him last Monday on Raw.
And Jarrett now sleeper on the Road Dogg after Road Dogg came off the ropes. What a huge match for the Road Dogg next Sunday on pay-per-view.
Ooh,
oh my, there's the left hand. Road Dogg teams with X-Pac to take on Mr. Ass in China. The right to DX. Jarrett gets the shoulder up.
But X-Pac and the Road Dogg, they want the name for what it represents, the attitude. They don't care about the dollars and cents. They want what it means in the heart.
And here comes Road Dogg now up over the top, and Jeff Jarrett's in trouble. And look at Deborah on the apron. Puppies are out. The puppies are out. And Jeff Jarrett now with the Intercontinental Championship gold. Road Dogg. Oh, my. Jeff Jarrett just pulled referee Tim White in front of that shot by Road Dogg. And the referee's out. And the Road Dogg now compared to slam time.
New champion. New champion.
Hook of the leg. We should have a new champion here. Referee Mike Chioda down.
And wait a minute. Well, referee Mike Chioda apparently is going to disqualify Jeff Jarrett in Tim White's name.
Chain. Oh, man. And China and Mr. Ass.
Oh, Michael. Look at this. We've seen this before.
China hammering away on the Road Dogg.
Listen to that steel crack against his skull.
Here we go now. Look out. X-Pac. The cavalry's arrived. Oh, what a war it's going to be next Sunday. The right to DX on the line. China and Mr. Ass against X-Pac.
It's a battle of money versus attitude, Michael, but it's DX to the core. It's a battle of pride and honor.
And that battle takes place next Sunday on paper. There's the Big Show. He meets Triple H later tonight.
Wonder what his reaction will be to The Undertaker and Kane's being here tonight.
We're back smoking on Sunday Night Heat in a very controversial champion, the European champion, joining us now for commentary at ringside.
European champion here joining us on Sunday Night Heat. Your opponent next Sunday at Fully Loaded. We're getting set to see in action here on Sunday Night Heat. Vidian, welcome to the broadcast.
First of all, slave. I'm here for one reason and one reason only. Have you ever had a dream that you were so sure was real? When you woke up, you couldn't tell the real world from the dream world? Well, this is a world in which I live. And this Sunday at Fully Loaded, D'Lo Brown will cross over into my world.
And here comes D'Lo Brown, and conspicuous by his absence, D'Lo's tag team partner, Sexual Chocolate, who's been barred from competition for high blood pressure. We asked D'Lo how Mark's doing.
See, don't worry about the big dog. He's going to be okay. Midian, you're damn right you're on my mind. It really gets on my nerves to walk out of the European title. We'll come fully loaded, Midian. Things are going to change. I will once again be the European champion. But first, things first. Tonight, Gangrel, you want to get in my way? What you need to do is you need to back up two steps, bend over, pick up your little punk card, because I'm going to mow you the hell over.
And you know, D'Lo Brown has a real vendetta against Midian. D'Lo wants the European title back.
Who does he think he is?
So D'Lo Brown set to take on Gangrel. What should be an interesting matchup as you see Midian looking on.
Turns to fear. There is no escape.
Don't you love it here?
From the haunting. Liam Neeson. Catherine Zeta-Jones. This summer, come out of the heat and into a chill. The Haunting, rated PG-13, starts this Friday.
God, I just get goosebumps from looking at that. And Gangrel's a person who'll give you nightmares as well. What a battle this is going to be.
Should be a tremendous matchup. Gangrel to take on D'Lo Brown. And with all due respect, champ, I thought the European Championship had been retired.
Do you see it here in front of you, Michael Cole? Obviously, it hasn't been retired. And I'm getting a little sick of all these people saying it's questionable the way that I got this belt. Are you insulting the way that I got it? Are you saying that I wasn't smart enough to win it?
Not at all, but your opponent next Sunday at Fully Loaded, D'Lo Brown, is definitely serious about regaining this title. He is a former champion.
Well, a lot of people are former things. A lot of people are a lot of former things. I happen to be the European champion right now. And you slave, will all learn.
Why are you calling us slaves?
You're all slaves. Until you've been enlightened like I have, there's nothing but slavery out there for you.
Look at that back body drop by D'Lo Brown in control now. And oh, man, what a clothesline by D'Lo. So the Undertaker's really changed your life, hasn't he?
The Undertaker's changed my life. The Undertaker is my life. Whatever he says goes. Whatever he says, I take like it's a commandment. So changing my life, bettering my life.
Gangrel now with a rip of the leg that time, and now he takes control of D'Lo Brown. Look out! Into those steel steps there. Gangrel's gotten very nasty lately. We saw him throw Edge into a pit of fire last Monday on Raw, and the rivalry between Gangrel and Edge is far from over.
Gangrel's anger focused on Edge. There's been rumors that Gangrel is jealous of all the accolades, all the support that Edge has received over the past few weeks from the fans. Here's a cover by Gangrel and a kick out after two.
Let's not forget, though, it was Gangrel that brought Edge and Christian into the World Wrestling Federation.
European title will be on the line next Sunday, Fully Loaded. Two-time European champ D'Lo Brown wants that championship back, but he's going to have his hands full with the man who's joining us, Midian.
Certainly is going to be a very physical battle, but D'Lo is used to that. Look at this, tremendous agility from D'Lo Brown.
Leg drop across the sternum that time, and D'Lo Brown telling Gangrel what he thinks about him. Big right hand by D'Lo. Look out, Gangrel, reversal. D'Lo off the ropes now. Wow!
Wait a minute, Midian, what are you doing? We invite you down for commentary, not to get involved in this matchup.
And D'Lo and Midian now will meet next Sunday, having words.
Michael, take a look. Gangrel on the far side.
And D'Lo now with the right hand. And Midian back joining us here.
Oh, my! Gangrel just spit that liquid into the face of D'Lo. And there's the impaler. There's two. It's over.
D'Lo Brown.
Between Edge and Gangrel, far
Road Dog, where are you going?
Where am I going? I may go to the boat docks to find me a battleship chain, because tomorrow night, China, on Raw, if you got the cojones, and I think that you do, we're going to do it doggy style. And sister, don't flatter yourself, because all that means is I'm going to put a chain around my neck, a chain around yours, and then I'm whooping your ass.
Whoa, man, Road Dog's out of here, but leaves with a challenge for China.
He makes the choice what to do.
And here comes X-Pac, who next Sunday will team with the Road Dog to take on Mr. Ass in China with the right to DX on the line. And speaking of DX, the original founder of D-Generation X, Shawn Michaels, will be in Kansas City this Friday. You have the opportunity to meet him at the Flamingo Casino from 2 to 3 p.m. as we get set for the debut of WWF SmackDown in Kansas City.
Music Volume 3. Hear the original entrance theme songs of your favorite WWF superstars. On sale now at all Coconut, Record Town, Camelot, and the Wall Music Store.
And by Wendy's Classic Hamburgers, it's Hamburger Bliss. And here comes the self-proclaimed Big Shot, the Big Shooter, Hardcore Holly. I don't know if Hardcore Holly's nuts or he's got a set of big ones, but this past week on Raw, he took on the Acolytes.
Both the Acolytes, Michael. Hardcore Holly suffered a tremendous beating at the hands of both of these two destructive men. And it was there that the Big Show came out. It was Holly's saving grace. Apparently, Big Show's kind of amused by Holly. Holly was overheard saying he had both the Acolytes right where he wanted them.
Hey, you know, this has got to be some kind of joke. I told them back there I was not wrestling X-Pac tonight because I am a super heavyweight.
What? A super heavyweight? Please.
He's not even in my league, so this match is not going to take place tonight.
I guess he doesn't want to hurt the kid. And X-Pac, to the right hand, doesn't want to hear any of the super heavyweight talk. Tell you what, following Sunday Night Heat, the premiere of G versus E. I can't wait, right here on USA.
Yeah, real dark humor comedy, and I understand Mankind's going to be in a future episode of G versus E.
What a spinning heel kick by X-Pac, and Hardcore Holly, the so-called super heavyweight, is getting beaten up here. You know, X-Pac's best friend Kane apparently has turned his back on his buddy, rejoining The Undertaker. You saw it tonight on Heat. Nobody home as Hardcore Holly jumps out of the way, and I guess the Big Shot's going to get Hardcore on X-Pac here. He's got a steel chair. Oh man!
This isn't a Hardcore match. That's going to be a disqualification.
Referee asks for the bell.
Wait a minute. Well, here comes Kane.
Well, maybe Kane hasn't abandoned his friend X-Pac.
Yeah, but wait a minute. He has a lot of history with Hardcore Holly as well.
And Hardcore Holly, the idiot, isn't even backing down. He's staying right in there.
Well, he's the Big Shot. Look at him.
He's received how many choke slams in the past 3 weeks from this guy? And look at him. And he's going to go for the ride again.
I think he's going to get one more right here.
Top floor. Going down. Choke slam.
Uh-oh. Wait a minute.
Well, the Big Show's amused by Holly. I really think he likes Hardcore Holly. And I'll tell you what, next Sunday at Fully Loaded, Big Show, Kane, one-on-one, and somehow Holly's weaseled his way in as the referee of that match.
Big Show versus Kane is no laughing matter, though. It looks like these two men are going to go at it right here.
And Kane now with a right hand, look out from behind. X-Pac with a chair to the back of the head of the Big Show.
X-Pac coming to the aid of his friend Kane. And now, wait a minute, The Undertaker.
What in the world's going to happen now? Kane's older brother, The Undertaker, who claimed earlier on tonight that the reunion to squeeze with Kane. And as Kane goes to rejoin his brother, that last glance back at X-Pac. And now it looks like the Big Show is going to call X-Pac a flight home. Revenge for that chair shot. And look at the strength of this 7 foot 2 inch, 500 pound man. The Big Show sending a message to both The Undertaker and Kane. And Michael, just like Stone Cold Steve Austin has to be wary of the brothers reuniting, certainly Kane and The Undertaker being back together again could have a pronounced effect on The Big Show next Sunday at Fully Loaded. And Big Show with his little buddy, so to speak, Hardcore Holly, who will be the special guest referee when The Big Show squares off against Kane next Sunday.
Holly's probably telling him, wait a minute,
the world's most dangerous man, Ken Shamrock, on his way to the arena. He's going to have plenty to say.
First of all, let me say this. My broadcast partner, JR, you know, the guy with a big head so big he wears the 20-gallon hat, sits over there, he has referred to you as not the sharpest knife in the drawer. Now, I know you're not going to prove him right by coming out here with some sort of challenge for Steve Blackman after what all Blackman has done to you the past few weeks.
Well, first of all, I ain't here to talk about you.
Huh?
I'm here to tell these people a little something about myself. See, there was a time when I had nothing but the clothes on my back, and I had a reputation as being the toughest guy around. See, there'd be times at 4 o'clock in the morning where people would be knocking on my door and telling me that there's some guy down at the local bar shooting off his mouth about how he could kick my ass. So naturally, I would walk into my room and I'd throw my sweats on, and I'd go outside and get in my car and I'd drive down to the bar. And as I walked up, there was a circle of cars with the lights on. And there was some big mouth punk standing in the middle of it. And when I walked into that circle of cars, one man walked out. One. And Blackman, that's how I want you, in the Iron Circle. See, I used to do this for fun and when I needed the money, but now it's personal. See, I know the WWF would never sanction anything like this. So Steve, this Sunday at the pay-per-view in the Iron Circle, I'm going to have expense on your ass!
When you look up the term intensity in the dictionary, Ken Shamrock's picture is next to it.
Michael, I can only imagine what will happen inside the Iron Circle. Steve Blackman, Ken Shamrock, next Sunday at Fully Loaded.
The world's most dangerous man, Ken Shamrock, is the Big Show and Triple H. Both get ready for a huge matchup tonight. Coming up next, exclusive footage from the press conference this past Wednesday. The return of Jesse the Body Ventura to the WWF at SummerSlam.
It is time to bring back some law and order.
The biggest story of the summer. You have to live in a hole not to know that Jesse the Body Ventura is returning to the WWF.
And it is indeed an honor to announce that the guest referee in the World Wrestling Federation Championship match to be held at SummerSlam at the Target Center will be Jesse the Body Ventura.
It is time to bring back some law and order. And that will be my job at SummerSlam August 22nd for the championship match. Because I rule here. I am bigger than you, McMahon. I'm more powerful than you. It's the body rules. It's my rules or the highway.
But the question still remains, which two superstars will be in the main event at SummerSlam? The main event in which Jesse the Body Ventura will be the special guest referee. And we'll find out next Sunday at Fully Loaded, only on pay-per-view. Well, things are about to heat up here because here come the Acolytes.
Pulling tag team contest is scheduled for one fall, making their way to the ring from the corporate ministry at a combined weight of 613 pounds. Bradshaw and Farouk, the Acolyte.
The evil, destructive force of the Acolytes. Farouk and Bradshaw are marching their way to Fully Loaded. They look to regain the tag team titles. They are focused, driven, and determined, and perhaps the toughest tag team ever in the WWF. And speaking of Fully Loaded, Starburst Hard Candy presents WWF Fully Loaded next Sunday live, exclusively on pay-per-view. Starburst Hard Candy, give it some juice. Certainly is a level playing field these days with the tag teams. The Hardy Boys are the champions, but there are many, many teams gunning for their gold. Including these two.
At a combined weight of 626 pounds, Draws and Prince Albert.
So you got Prince Albert, the personal tattoo artist, and piercings for Draws, who's the Mad Hatter of the WWF, and he's wearing fishnet stockings.
Experimental phase, Michael. Let's not go crazy. Come on.
Didn't you do that at one time in your life?
What?
You know, try out some fishnets, maybe a mini skirt or two?
Please.
I don't think Bradshaw and Farouk like those fishnets. They're laughing at them. You talk about the equal balance in the tag team ranks here in the WWF. Any team can beat any other team at any point in time. And next Sunday on pay-per-view, the Hardy Boys and the Acolytes, tag titles on the line. Acolytes rules, no disqualification. However, the Hardy Boys will have a man advantage.
They certainly will. Michael Hayes, who has led the Hardy Boys with his experience and guidance, has brought the Hardy Boys along, will be an active participant. It'll be 3-on-2 for the tag team titles next Sunday at Fully Loaded on pay-per-view.
And Farouk and Bradshaw in foul mood since losing the tag team championship. Keep in mind, when the Hardy Boys defeated the Acolytes, Bradshaw had something from a concussion, and here come Michael Hayes and the champs.
Coming down to get a closer look, and Bradshaw's eyes beaming right up the ramp.
Oh! And how about that challenge from Ken Shamrock to the Lethal Weapon for next Sunday at Fully Loaded, an Iron Circle match.
Oh!
Here's a cover by Prince Albert, hooked in the leg. He says, no, not now.
Shamrock and Blackman, their brutal rivalry next Sunday.
Here's a cover now by Prince Albert, kick out. Steve Blackman, the silent assassin, the hired gun of the McMahon family, in action tomorrow night on Raw in a match set up by Shane McMahon as he takes on Stephanie McMahon's boyfriend, Tess.
Well, I guess Tess must really like Stephanie to continue their relationship and continue to fight all assailants. Shane McMahon continuing to put the pressure on.
And Stephanie McMahon is okay after that inadvertent elbow this past week on Raw by Shane.
Yeah, maybe Shane will finally learn his lesson and lighten up a little bit.
And here's Bradshaw now. He's not lightening up on Prince Albert. Reversal. Bradshaw whipped into the corner. And here comes the 330-pounder. Wow. And Prince Albert follows it up with a clothesline.
We always talk about Prince Albert and his case full of tattooing instruments, but
the Godfather and Val Venus, they have an issue as well with Prince Albert and Draws and the Acolytes and the Hardy Boys. Oh, man. And some problems outside the ring now.
Problems inside the ring for Draws. Bradshaw and Farouk now beginning to assert the double team.
And Farouk with that right hand to the ribs of Draws.
A lot of trash being talked out here, Michael.
Bradshaw looking on. Farouk hammering away at Draws.
Referee is out of position.
Hook of the leg by Farouk and a kick out by Draws in a potentially explosive situation outside the ring.
And potentially explosive tomorrow night on Raw as well, where we will see perhaps the end of an era for the final time. We're either going to see Stone Cold Steve Austin as the WWF champion or Mr. McMahon final Raw appearance perhaps tomorrow night.
Now look at Farouk now knocking Draws outside the ring right out here in front of us.
That puts the rock of Mr. Ass in the hole. Yeah, I think in this replay you'll clearly see Prince Albert's involvement. The referee was on the other side of the ring and didn't see Prince Albert holding Farouk's foot. But when the referee finally got into position, the three count was scored and a victory for Drives and Prince Albert.
And the Acolytes with plenty to say. They have a date next Sunday against the Hardy Boys with the WWF Tag Team titles on the line and fully loaded on pay-per-view. And here comes Triple H along with China on their way to the arena. A huge matchup coming up next on Heat. What's going to happen when Triple H collides with that man? 7 feet two, 500 pounds on the Big Show. Heat.
Champion Stone Cold Steve Austin, the challenger, Undertaker. First blood for the WWF Championship.
The first man to bleed loses. It's that simple.
Austin, your blood will flow.
K-Bash, aura bitch.
First blood to seal the end of an era.
Austin, somebody's got to go and go for good.
When I beat the Undertakers, we will see you later.
WWF Fully Loaded, presented live by Starburst Heart Candy, next Sunday on pay-per-view.
And here comes Triple H, accompanied by China. And what a classic showdown next Sunday at Fully Loaded on pay-per-view to determine the number one contender for the main event at SummerSlam. Triple H and The Rock in the Fully Loaded strap match.
We have seen The Rock battle Triple H before, but never, Michael, have the stakes been higher. The opportunity to emerge from the Fully Loaded strap match as the number one contender to head to the main event in the WWF Championship match at SummerSlam.
No disqualification, no countouts, falls count anywhere. You must win by pinfall. And the winner will meet the WWF Champion in the main event at SummerSlam with Jesse the Body Ventura as the special guest referee.
So while we know that The Rock and Triple H will battle to see who the number one contender is, the question, Michael, is who will the champion be? Will it be Stone Cold Steve Austin or The Undertaker? We'll find out next Sunday as well.
And as Triple H prepares for that match against The Rock, boy, oh boy, is he going to have his hands full tonight on Heat. 7 feet two, 500 pounds of the Big Show, who gets sent next Sunday on pay-per-view to be King with Hardcore Holly as a special guest referee.
The intensity, the look in the eye of the Big Show.
What a war this is going to be for Heat. Triple H, the Big Show. China also involved in Fully Loaded as she teams with Mr. Ass to meet Road Dogg and X-Pac, the right to D-Generation X on the line. But there's going to be so much at stake, Kevin, in Fully Loaded. Big Show and Kane, some serious bad blood between those two.
And let's not forget, Michael, that it was the Big Show who first fostered the collusion theory with The Undertaker and Kane now having reunited.
And what will that reunification mean for the WWF Championship match at Fully Loaded next Sunday? The first blood match, The Undertaker and Stone Cold. If Austin wins, Vince McMahon steps down as chairman. If Austin loses, Stone Cold never gets a WWF title shot again. And Big Show now in control of Triple H early on. And Kevin, the immortal battle between good and evil begins tonight.
That's right. Find out who's G and who's E on the premiere of USA Network's new original series, G versus E, coming up right after Heat.
And here's Triple H now hammering away on the Big Show with those right hands. The Big Show staggering a little bit. Can Triple H knock the big guy off his feet? Those taped fists are almost like a propellant, fueling the fire of those right hands, weakening the Big Show. And the Big Show, the seven-footer, looks like a tree about to be knocked down, but perhaps he was playing possum. And there goes Triple H over the top rope. China at ringside, of course, in support of Triple H. She'll be in action tomorrow night on Raw. The Road Dog challenging China to a dog pound match.
Certainly any time the battle carries out to the floor, you got to keep in mind China's presence. Even if you are the Big Show, China doesn't care. She's a threat no matter how big you are.
You talked about the reunification of The Undertaker and Kane and what that could perhaps mean for Stone Cold Steve Austin next Sunday at Fully Loaded. But what about what that reunification is going to mean for the rest of the superstars in the WWF, including the Big Show?
Certainly the Big Show versus Kane, that might be an indication. Wait a minute.
You heard the Big Show's skull crack the steel on the outside. And we spoke about China's presence, and it definitely has taken shape here on Sunday Night Heat. And Triple H now with a steel chair, perhaps trying to even the odds a little bit against the 7'2" monster, the Big Show.
Wait a minute now, wait a minute.
China now on the edge of the ring.